Mike grew up in a tough neighbourhood on the far eastern edge of Brooklyn, a place called Brownsville.
God, this is wild.
By 1976, Mike, aged 10, had been abandoned by his father and lived with his mother, brother, and sister on Atlantic Avenue.
2178 was my building. This was my apartment right here.
It was as a child adrift on these streets that Mike first connected with the birds.
Glad to see you, man. Remember you used to fly the bird? Yeah, oh, you still got it?
Yeah. Pigeons were big. You know, there were guys over here that had pigeons. They had Danny had pigeons over here, Chucky. All these guys had pigeons on this side too, you know? And we used to go over there and try to tap them off and steal their birds and stuff. I had horrible pigeons. They couldn't fly much, but they were beautiful. And they were just show birds. And I was really insecure about letting some quality pigeons out because I didn't know about training them. I just wanted to possess them, you know? But in order to possess them, you have to let them go. You can't imprison them. You have to have the freedom. They have to be on their will to come with you. And that's where you get the gratitude to believe that they're here because they love me. This bird has a bond with me. This is my bird.
In his troubled childhood, the birds provided Mike with a love and comfort he couldn't get elsewhere.
I never went to school because I got bullied all the time. That's how I got involved with pigeons, because I was skipping school to avoid the bullies. My life sucked as a kid. I was just bullied all. I hate my childhood life. But, you know, it is what it is.
A former world champion boxer may be greeted like a long-lost son. But for Tyson, Brownsville was never a happy home.
Thank you, baby. I love you.
I don't miss this neighborhood, but I'm proud that I'm from here. I'm proud. Yeah, I'm proud.